Tokyo. It's an incredible city with bright lights and busy streets. You can find almost anything here, from rich culture to authentic cuisines and endless entertainment. Many people travel to Tokyo in search of new experiences and leave with everlasting memories. And some take a step deeper and find ways to move to this urban metropolis. Now, as awesome as Tokyo is when traveling, living in the city is a completely different experience and has its pros and cons. And those that find a way to move to Tokyo are left with the question, should I live in the bustling city itself or in one of its suburbs? For the past 3 years, I've lived in Tokyo, and about 2 months ago, I moved to a remote part of Chiba. So today I'll be showing you what it's like to live in Tokyo versus Chiba and the pros and cons of both. Let's get into it. So first, I think it's important to discuss what affects rent prices in Japan, especially near big cities like Tokyo and Osaka. And the main factors are the size of the room, the type of accommodation, whether it's a house, apartment, or condo, aka mansion, the city, ward, or area, how far it is from the nearest station and how accessible that station is to other parts of the city, and finally the age of the building or when it was built. After that, there's a couple of smaller factors, which includes whether it has tatami or wooden flooring, having a security entrance or not, whether it's a combined toilet and shower or separate, what floor it's on, even which direction the window is facing, and many other additional features. So let's start with my new apartment here in Chiba. This apartment is 1LDK, which stands for Living, Dining, and Kitchen, and has a size of 50 square meters. This place was built in 2021, which means it's completely new and we're actually the first to live here. It's located in a fairly remote part of Chiba, and you have to take a bus to the nearest station because it's too far. And finally, the rent is 67,000 yen, which includes Wi-Fi. So within those 50 square meters, here is what you get.
So starting from the entrance, there's a hallway that leads to the house, but here we have a closet space and another closet space. And once we enter, we're in the living room. We have our TV, table, and sofa. And over here we have an indoor veranda where we can put some stuff and dry clothes. And to the left, we have our kitchen, our sink, some countertop space, and a built-in IH stove. And we have our little storage space here, and our fridge, and a bunch of rice. Now heading into the room, it's nice and spacious. We bought a new bed because our old one was way too small. And this is where we have a desk where I do work. And on this side is where I keep all my camera gear, and here we have a closet. It is a very wide walk-in closet. We have some storage space up here and all of our clothes. And heading over here, we have our toilet. Came with a bidet over here. Some storage space again. Next to the toilet, we have another storage space where we keep our cleaning stuff, and yeah. And we have a sink area here and our washing machine. And finally, our bath space here. It's a pretty wide area. Ooh. You can wash up here and you can use the bathtub in there. And from the outside, you can control the fan. So this is drying, warm air, I don't know what this is, and ventilation. And from the kitchen, we have this little control panel, and you can control the water in the bathtub. So if you click on this, the bathtub will start to fill up. You can set a timer, and you can make an appointment. Yeah.
So since the home is brand new, everything inside is pretty clean. And for 50 square meters, you get quite a lot with this apartment. Everything inside the home is nice, but in exchange for that, our place is located in quite an inconvenient area. In fact, most people in this area drive cars instead of taking public transportation, which is quite uncommon near big cities like Tokyo. And that's actually quite a common trade-off in Japan. The further you live in a station, the wider and cleaner the rooms are for the same amount of money. For this amount of space and quality in our old Tokyo neighborhood, it'll cost at least around 200,000 yen per month. And on that note, let's take you guys through our old Tokyo apartment. This apartment is a 1R, which means it comes with one room and no living space or dining space. The size of this apartment is 23 meters squared, which means it's less than half the size of our new place, but it's a fairly decent size for a studio. This place was built in 2007, which means it's 14 years old, but it still has fairly good condition. It's located in Shinjuku Ward, and it's 6 minutes away from the Kagurazaka Station, which is on the Tozai Line, and 15 minutes away from Iidabashi Station. The rent was 80,000 yen per month, and I paid for my own internet. So let's take you guys on a tour inside. So as you walk in, there's a hallway with somewhat of a kitchen and a space for your washing machine. And at the end of the hallway, there's a door that leads to the room, and it's a fairly large size room. It's bigger than the one we have now. There's a separate toilet and shower space, which is nice because many cheaper apartments have the toilet in the shower space, which is quite inconvenient. And right above the hallway, there's a loft, which isn't big enough to fit people, so it was used as storage. And on the other side of the room, there is a small closet space. And next to that is a balcony, which was too small, so we hardly even used that. So the room itself is fairly simple and clean, and it was quite comfortable living there. 80,000 yen is a little bit more expensive than what I would consider the average is. You'll be able to find a similar room for about 60 to 70,000 yen per month. But as you may have noticed, the biggest merit about living here isn't the room, it's the location. This place is located 6 minutes away from the Kagurazaka Station, which is quite famous, but nonetheless, it's on the Tozai Line, which is one of the biggest lines in Tokyo. And on top of that, it's 15 minutes away from Iidabashi Station, which has 6 different train lines running through it, which makes this place super convenient. Let me give you an example of how convenient this place is. From our old Tokyo apartment, it takes 10 minutes to get to Tokyo Station and Ikebukuro Station, 20 minutes to Shinjuku and Shibuya Station, and finally 30 minutes to Disneyland. And this is exactly the reason why I decided to pick this place. Before Corona, I had to go to different locations for work, and living near Iidabashi Station made it super convenient to get to everywhere I had to. Now, comparing our old and new place is quite an extreme comparison, since we went from living in the heart of the city to the middle of nowhere. And many people actually choose to live in between, in a neighborhood slightly separated from the city center, or maybe in a neighboring prefecture near a train line that runs to Tokyo. And many people choose to live in these areas because you have a balance of quality and size room, far better than what you'd find in Tokyo for the same price, and you have a fairly decent access to the main parts of the city. But the further you live from the city center, the longer the walk might be to the nearest station. So that was it for comparing our old and new apartment. Hopefully that gave you some insight for choosing your next home in Tokyo. If you found this helpful, make sure to leave a like. And if you're going to be moving soon in Japan, make sure to check out our previous video, which I'll link up in the info card. And finally, if you want to see more Japan life and travel videos, make sure to subscribe. Alright, that's it for today, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace!